I hope I don't take more than 3 minutes just to set it up. Okay, as I said, ABB, when we look at the power scenario in future, we look at it in 6 different segments, that this is what is going to happen. So I am not limiting it only to grid stability, but something of power systems in the future. And in 3 minutes, obviously, I cannot really cover everything, but then there are a few key topics which I wanted to really choose out of this. One out of this is business models, because these business models are changing, and they are changing very, very fast. And one topic I wanted to take was microgrids. That is something which is very, very fresh for us, new for us. ABB also has set up this business only around 1.5 years back. And we would really like to see that, you know, this business grows and it prospers here. We also have digitalization, which we are taking into various substations, and we are talking about it. So that is also something new. Now, when it comes to microgrids, what we are looking at very clearly is the renewables. The renewables is the way to go, and this is happening basically because of environment as well as the cost reasons. So everybody will slowly move towards renewables. Yes, the percentages may vary, but that is bound to happen. I think one point which was made by BSES very well was that, you know, they see the application of these kind of storage devices, batteries, or microgrids really in cities also, just to give the stability to the grid, so you don't have power cuts and things like that. We also see a lot of applications for microgrids in remote areas, wherein it is very difficult to provide access to electricity. And if you set up a microgrid, that really changes the lives of those people. Like, let's say you imagine there is a village of around 200 people, 300 people, in a very remote village wherein transmission line cannot take the power there. You set up a microgrid, the quality of life of those 300 people changes drastically. And that is something which is unique. Now, coming to business models, how can this be done? Because if we tell that you set up a microgrid and put the capex for that from those 300 people, this is an impossible task. It will not happen. It will never happen. Okay. So how do we do that? One of the ways what we really recommend, or we find, and especially we would request all the power companies to really do this, is most of the companies today, they have what is called as corporate social responsibility funding. So most of the companies have some kind of funding, 2% or 3% of their profits towards this. Why don't we really spend money here? That is something which can be done. And yes, I agree. When it comes to CSR, there are a lot many activities which can, or funding can go to various directions apart from only power. But at least the power companies, I would request that, you know, you could really take the lead here and do some kind of funding there, which really helps. Because those villages afterwards, they can really bear the OPEX cost. That is not a problem. But the CAPEX is something which is very, very important, and that can be done. Similarly, when it comes to, you know, the Team Sweden, I think there are many projects wherein they just go haywire because of lack of funding. So if it is possible, if you can bring funding there, then we can together talk and really take this forward. Okay. We would also be making some points on the EV charging, but I think we will take it up separately when it comes during the discussion. But from my side, that's it. Hopefully, I have covered it in 3 minutes.